I don't know. I've tried to avoid talking about money, just because it's such a sensitive subject. But I think after a bunch of these comments that we've been getting, I think it's time to talk about money.
The subject of money. I'm an
Mo
artist and I need to manage my money.
Rafi's Rambles.
Hola, you amazing artist. Money. Talking about money. Money. So I decided I'm going to talk to you guys about money because it seems like this week I've been getting a lot of questions about money. This video is inspired by Biscuit Blue. People never told me I was going to fail because I'm too scared of telling them that I want to be an artist in some way. Well, I'm actually scared of screwing up and living on Cheerios and dirty water for the rest of my life. I mean, how can I be sure I'm going to make any money? I'm so socially awkward, I won't even be able to ask for money after a commission. That's one of the biggest fears that there is out there, is that you're going to pursue your art career and you're not going to make any money because of the artistic stereotype that's out there of the starving artist. It is extremely risky, but not any more risky than anybody who decides that they're going to start a business on their own.
Also, Cheerios, they're not so bad. And clean water is not very expensive, so don't go for the dirty water.
I mean, that is an interesting way of putting it. Cheerios and dirty water.
The imagery of Cheerios and dirty water could shake anyone to their core.
So you're afraid because you're socially awkward. Well, guess what? I'm socially awkward.
I might be the most socially awkward human that's ever lived.
Yeah, that's true. This weekend we did an event where there was a lot of people there and everybody was talking, and I had to like step outside because it was just overwhelming. It's okay, you're gonna be socially awkward. You're gonna have a hard time the first times that you're asking for money to ask for money. I still have difficulty with that. You could push through that. You could be whoever it is that you wanna be. You could believe whatever it is that you want to believe. Now, if you choose to believe that you're socially awkward and you can't function in that world and you're not going to succeed because of that, then fine, you let your limitations hold you back. But if not, push through it, because we're artists. We are the most socially awkward.
I expect, if I'm talking to an artist, for them to be a little bit weird.
Yeah, they're weird. You're afraid of screwing up because if you screw up, you're going to eat Cheerios and drink dirty water. Well, the fact is, you're going to screw up. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to make wrong decisions. You gotta be okay with that. This is a learning experience. There is no guidebook on how Rafi should become an artist. I just have to figure this out as I go. The only difference is that I know no matter what comes, even if I get down or get depressed because, oh, things aren't working out the way that I want them, that eventually I'm going to figure it out. I'm going to figure something out. It's going to work out for me. And that's what keeps me going. How can I be sure that I'm going to make money? Well, the truth of the matter is that you're not going to be sure. This is not something that is surrounded in security. Like, from week to week, I'm not sure how much money I'm going to make. The only thing that I know for sure is that sense of security that a lot of people have from going to what they call a stable job, it's an imaginary thing. It doesn't exist. I understand where you're coming from because for years, that's pretty much the world that I lived in. I lived in the world of I needed to make sure that I knew where my paycheck was going to come from, was very secure in my job, spent a lot of hours working, making a lot of money for this company. So this boss of a company came and had this big, huge meeting and told us, listen, I know that there are rumors that we're going bankrupt. The fact of the matter is that we're not going bankrupt. I saw my business up for sale in the newspaper, and I knew right then and there that our company was declaring bankruptcy and I was gonna be out of a job. I left that job and went to job number two, and now I had a higher position. I was in management and in training, worked a lot of hours and made a lot of money for the company and did a lot of sacrificing for this company. About 6 years into it, my grandfather passed away and he meant the world to me. And unfortunately, because I was working so many hours, I wasn't able to make it to the hospital in time to see him. That was a devastating blow for me, and I kind of fell into a deep depression, and I asked for some time off. Well, at the time, we were kind of short-staffed, and my boss said no. So I took the time off anyway. I was fired because I took that leave of absence. So I had no job, no security. You know, and that's the thing. It's like you have this idea that if you do this and you fall in line, you're going to have job security. And really, it's just a myth. You spend a lot of time working really, really hard so that you can keep your job, so that you could have some kind of sense of security. But the fact is that is not real. Something as scary as this, where there is no sense of security here, I have no idea if next week is going to be a good week or a bad week. All I know for sure, this is what I'm going to do no matter what. And if we run into a financial roadblock, we will figure it out. We will keep moving forward and keep going, because it won't be a forever thing. It's not easy, and you have to really, really have your mindset in it. You really have to understand and be able to believe in your ability to push through something, because you will have rough times. If you are doing anything that is not considered normal, or you are starting your own business or doing something maybe is not as secure or stable as another job, you are taking a risk. In my mind, the question should be like, if the shit hits the fan, am I willing to put in whatever it is that I need to put in to make this work? Or am I going to fall apart because I don't believe enough in myself? So whenever I read these comments about people that are worried about whether or not they're going to be making money, or there was one comment of like, yeah, you know, and then if your art doesn't sell, you become a failed artist and you live on the street. It's like, is that it? Is that the end of the story? Like, that's what you've imagined now, that you're going to eat Cheerios and dirty water and that's it for you? Like, you're just going to be happy living that way? And your only alternative is that you have to go get some job that you hate? Or do you think to yourself, like, you know what? No, I'm going to make this work. I'm going to do this. Despite all the naysayers, despite everybody telling me that I'm going to fail, despite all the cultural ideas of what it means to be an artist and how you're supposed to be starving, I'm going to make it work, or you just give up. I mean, and that's the truth. The truth of the matter is that the only way that you could truly, really fail is if you give up. You're gonna run into some roadblocks. You're gonna run into some hard times. You're gonna run into a bunch of things that are going to discourage you from moving forward in your art career. But if you just already give up in your mind before you even start, how are you gonna make it through that roadblock? I think I'm getting a little like, I'm not saying to like quit your job and just go and do this thing. If you feel more comfortable working while you're doing your art, then find a job that allows you the freedom to be able to work on your art as well. I know plenty of artists that have a full-time job and they do shows and exhibitions and stuff, because worrying about money will stifle your creativity. So, I mean, if you do jump both legs into this, then you have to somehow work it out in your mind that I'm not going to worry about money anymore, regardless of how much money I have. But if you can't find yourself doing that, then get a job and do your art. Go to work, and then when you're not at work, you are working on your art career. So I'm gonna leave you with this. The more artwork you create, the more possibility that there is to sell it. Eventually, every single piece is going to sell. So for me personally, whenever I create a piece, in my mind, that's money in the bank. This is $300 that I just created. This is another $400 that I just created. That's $1,000 that I just created. You might run into a roadblock, or something won't work out, or a certain project will fail, but it doesn't mean that you're a failure at whatever it is that you're trying to do. It just means that that thing failed, and then you walk past it, you learn from the experience, and you keep going. And as long as you keep going, you can't help but succeed at some point in time, whatever it is that you deem that is success. Hopefully I covered everything that Biscuit Blue had in that question, because that was one of those questions that I read and I was like, whoa, okay. So it's gonna be all right. You are awesome. You are going to do awesome. I totally believe in you.
Got this, Biscuit Blue.
You've got this.
It's whatever cereal you want, and clean water.
That's right. I really hope you guys found this helpful. And if you did, just leave me a thumbs up. And thank you so much for watching, you guys. I totally freaking adore you. The feedback that I've been getting from you, you guys are so freaking awesome. Thank you. And if you guys are watching for the first time and you'd like to subscribe for more content like this, just click right over here to subscribe. And that's it. Stay awesome, you guys. Say goodbye, Klee.
Good day.
Adios.